أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد الهادي الأمين وعلى آله وجنده الطيبين الطاهرين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. When the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام was conveying the message to the people of Quraysh, then they came up with a strange question. They told him, انسب لنا ربك, that tell us what the lineage of your Lord is. Everything has to be related to something. You know, smart people, when it comes to worldly things, but when it comes to the religion, they will have all these kind of weird ideas and illogical ideas. So they told him that, well, who is that Lord related to? If you're talking about somebody who is great. And then the answer came.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد. الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
In a hadith narrated in Bukhari and Muslim by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, Surah قل هو الله أحد is equivalent to one third of the Quran. And there's an interesting story about one of the an Ansari, Sahabi عليه رضوان الله, who used to always lead people in the Salat by reciting قل هو الله أحد. Until they came and complained to the Prophet. At first they complained to him. They told him, how come you always do that? He said to them that this is all what I have. Either you take it or you don't pray behind me. And they complained to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. The Prophet asked him, how come you always read with قل هو الله أحد? And the man used to memorize much of the Quran. And the Sahabi عليه رضوان الله said, because it is the attribute or the description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so I love to read it. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you because you love this surah. The greatest surah in the whole Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Now of course the focus of the surah is the basic of belief, the aqidah, specifically the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it starts with قُلْ, say. And this say actually of course is part of the surah, but the significance of this beginning of the surah is to indicate that this aqidah comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah says قُلْ and then after that the description is given, it means that this description is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the aqidah actually comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the source of the set of belief and not our mind, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beyond actually our mind, and the Islamic aqidah does not contradict the mind even though it is beyond that. Then what is the value of our mind? Our mind will allow us to understand the truth, to understand the element of faith, but not to discover them from zero. These questions, the big elements and the big questions, have to be given to us. Our mind can understand them and determine their validity. And this is really what the aqidah actually plays, the role that the aqidah actually plays in the religion. And this is our manhaj, our path, is to receive that faith from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is for everybody, by the way. Nobody can arrive to the truth on their own. What our mind can tell us is that there is a creator beyond this world, beyond this universe. But the big questions, those can only be given, can only be answered from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is even to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى, that you were looking for the truth, not having that, looking for directions. You were going in a different direction, astray, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says,
وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانُ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ.
So we have revealed to you from ourselves, you use not to know what the book is nor what the belief is, but we have sent down to you a light. We guide whomever we wish among our servants. So Allah, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith al-Qudsi that, O my servants, all of you are astray except the one that I guide, then seek my guidance and I will give it to you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us guidance in this life and in the hereafter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us perseverance in this life and in the hereafter. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.